Dr. James Watua is a wildlife veterinarian and conservationist who grew up in Manafwa District, Eastern Uganda, where his love for animals began early in life. Through his 5 years of veterinary school at Makerere University, Watua donated his time to Uganda Wildlife Conservation Education Center, Entebbe Zoo, helping to diagnose, treat, and medicate zoo animals, in addition to providing medical care to hundreds of rescued and endangered animals.
My name is Dr. Watua James. I am a wildlife veterinarian and conservationist from Uganda. Taking care of wildlife for animals has been part of my life since childhood. And this love for wildlife inspired me to pursue a career as a veterinarian, particularly as a wildlife veterinarian. I have since kept on an active career of practice as a vet, working under supervision and guidance of experienced veterinarians from Uganda Wildlife Authority and other conservation organizations. And it's my inspiration to continue as a hands-on or practical field veterinarian for as long as it is possible and practical, and eventually to complete a PhD in this field.
In 2018, Dr. Watua earned a veterinary track scholarship under the Wildlife Conservation Network Scholarship Program, and this saw him complete his master's degree in science, wildlife health and management of Makerere University. While studying, Watua became concerned on how oil exploration might affect wildlife, with a focus on elephant well-being in Makshon Falls National Park, a natural habitat for the African elephants in Uganda. Watua's worry about the oil exploration amidst this wildlife national park prompted him to carry out a research on the well-being of elephants alongside the oil business.
Much as oil exploration has the potential to contribute to economic development of Uganda, it also poses a threat to keystone species like African bush elephants, giraffes, the lions of Makshon Falls National Park. Particularly the activities during and after oil mining, exploration and development activities may alter the welfare of such animals through causing habitat fragmentation, altering animal behavior, increasing stress, and therefore their susceptibility to a disease. The general objective of my study is to establish stress levels and parasite burdens in African elephants of Makshon Falls Park using hormonal parameters. Elephants are usually in the field. We follow the elephants, which are collared to see their foraging ranges and also to pick individual animal fecal samples for stress analysis. Once the samples are picked, they are usually transported to Makerere University, where laboratory analysis to establish stress levels and parasite burdens is carried out. In the field, there are several methods that are used to assess stress. My study is focusing on the use of glucocorticoids to assess the stress response because they give a better mechanistic understanding of the physiological stress that the African elephants may be responding to. To assess the parasites, several methods are being used. I'm particularly using flotation methods to assess or reveal the nematodes and cestode parasites that may be present in the fecal. But also I'm doing sedimentation and McMaster methods, which help to assess the trematodes as parasites of African elephants. And findings will be used to gauge the efficacy of wildlife health management practices and policies to guide conservation management. Preliminary findings so far indicate that there may be a strong association between stress and gastrointestinal parasites in African elephants, with prevalent parasites being strongyles and trichuris, in addition to coccidial parasites affecting majority of the female African elephants and juveniles in particular compared to their male counterparts. This study was not able to study parasites and stress over a long period so as to compare the dry and rainy seasons due to limited resources. However, it was able to compare parasites in June and July, which is the start of the dry season. It was unlikely to study other type of worms like trematodes due to a limited budget. However, samples have been archived for further studies depending on how funding comes in.